Welcome to the race 2023 here in Italy at Parco di Brenta. We're fishing for the biggest fish this week. Overall biggest fish wins the competition, but we've also got section winners, and also starting at 4 o'clock, we've got first fish wins £100 at the race. At the race in Italy, it's a peg draw. So basically put your name into the bag and what you pick out, that's the swim that you get. Peg four, my lucky swim. So all the guys have traveled in, some have flown in, some have drove in, and then we've had a look round, had a good scout out, I've been pointing out some good spots, some good positions, some tactics of how to fish. We've done the draw now, I didn't really get where I wanted. Peg six. Not bad bank, I said I didn't want to be up there. As we're fishing for the biggest fish of the week, I'm going to be in it, whether it's not a favoured swim or not, I'm going to be in it right till the end. Who's going to win the big fish competition?
Well, would you believe it? Literally half an hour after the start of the race, Harry over in Peg 9 landed the first fish of the week. And being the first fish of the week, Harry's just won himself £100 of tackle box vouchers. Great start here at the race 2023. To be honest, we couldn't have asked for a better start. We're only a couple of hours in and fish have been caught from all areas of the lake so far. First from Harry and Peg 9, then Ben in 14 had a couple of bites, then messages were flying in from 22. It really has been carnage. Although some lovely carp have been caught, the 40s and 50s aren't really the stamp that we'd expect to win it this week. Being Parco, we'd expect a 70 or even an 80 pounder to win it, and it'd be great to see a fish of that size caught for the cameras.
As for myself in Peg 6, as I thought, it's been a little bit quiet. I've been watching people around me spomming and bait boats and that going out, and that's made the fish move out into the middle areas, I think. Hopeful for tonight though, and what I've got coming in a minute is a 4 cheese pizza. The pizzas here are absolutely delicious.
As we step into the evening of day one, a few of the lads began opening their Italian accounts for the week. First being Mark over in Peg 3 with this breeze block of a mirror. At just under £50, it was a great way to get off the mark. But the real highlight of the evening was this epic scaly for John in Peg 13. Wow, check that carp out. The juices were well and truly flowing. I mean, with Parco it really does only take one fish to make that trip, and Matthew in Peg 1 was about to find that out for himself.
Very good morning to you. Got my lovely morning coffee made by Jason then. And Sunday morning at the race in Italy. Not so many fish caught last night. Didn't really kick off. Big one out of Peg 22, over £50. And the guys, I can hear spoms and that flying about and bait buckets opening up. Everyone's getting prepped for Sunday's fishing. I think there's going to be a few nice fish caught today.
Parco, famous for the ginormous, immaculate commons that reside in there. But this fish wasn't just a big old slab of gold, it also put Matt in the lead for the big fish competition. If you finish the week having caught the biggest fish, you get all of your money back from the trip and £500 of tackle box vouchers. That's why every bite gets the ticker going. You never know, that next bite could win you some serious money, and that's why people love the race. Fish were still coming out from all over. Well, I say all over, they seemed to be everywhere but Pete Swim. and with swim 2-3 to move into, Pete couldn't sit on his hands for any longer.
Bit short-lived up in peg 6, but sometimes you get that feeling that you've got to move, yeah? And I had that feeling, definitely. Took the opportunity before anyone else did. It is the race, and we'll see how we get on in peg 2.
Matt was into yet another big-looking carp. Tipping the scales to just under £56, the brute of a mirror was the second fish of the day for Matt after that mid-60 this morning. That's a brace of carp totaling over £110. This is what the race at Parco is all about.
Yep.
You actually look like you're smiling as well.
See, but Matthew wasn't the only one hauling. James over in peg 12 was starting to build up a serious hit of carp. Unlike the rest of the group, James had adopted a frequent baiting approach to keep the fish in his swim, even into darkness and through the early hours of the morning. It's certainly not for the faint-hearted, but you will be rewarded. As for Pete over in peg 2, the move had finally come good and he got off the mark for the race 2023.
Cracking £34 mirror to start my account at Parco. Guys in the swim just behind me in 22, it was a really bizarre take. It pulled to the top and I come out and thought it was a line. I just pulled the line back down again. And then it pulled to the top again and I was in. But even the fight was very slow and dogged. I've heard a couple of fish out here, guys hearing the fish in 22 as well. And the media crew heard some fish out in front of 2 early this morning. So I'm hoping tomorrow morning we can get some more fish and hopefully some bigger ones. Hopefully one twice this size. Always funny getting your first fish, always an unusual buzz, especially when people are catching all around the lake. However experienced you are, I know getting that first one in a bag to boost your confidence in what you're doing straight away. As soon as it's gone off there, I'm thinking, right, let's get that rod back on the spot. It's obviously catching and hopefully we can catch some more.
But Pete's carp wasn't the only one caught that night. You see, Ben over in peg 14 was starting to build up a serious hit of carp, and some real nice ones too. Could he win the race? Only time will tell.
Tuesday morning, caught my first fish last night that I was very, very happy about. It seems a little bit colder today, doesn't, you know, people are merging from their bivvies, definitely a little bit slower. But over in peg 1 here, we've got Matthew into a fish. Been a while now, we still haven't seen this fish. Matt's still bent into it. It's another potential big one for him. He's still in the lead anyway. Maybe he can take the lead even further. Barbecue day today as well, so everyone's looking forward to that later on this afternoon.
About
Just been for a walk around the lake, chatting to everyone, make sure everyone's all right. Looking forward to the barbecue this afternoon. Sat down having a bit of a chat with Josh in Peg 7, who's on 4 fish at the minute. And his middle rod's just ripped off right when we're sitting here. So hopefully this is a big fish.
It hasn't been a quick start for Josh, but he's stuck with his game plan of baiting heavy in the hope of holding numbers of fish. And as you can see, he's starting to reap the rewards for his efforts. After slipping back Josh's mirror, we received a call from Peg 1. Yep, you guessed it. Matthew was into yet another carp just before barbecue time.
Round here in Peg 1. Cracking common here with Matt. Will you put this rod back out then, Matt?
I was fishing on top of a bar at 4 metres and see them showing and fizzing behind, so moved the spot slightly and had one instantly, pretty much within 5-10 minutes.
So we're gonna have a break now then, 3:30, we're gonna have a couple of hours barbecue and then we're gonna get back out there and catch some more, hopefully get a big one. Still in the lead on Monday afternoon with 64.4.
In true race fashion, the barbecues aren't just about stuffing their faces with Italian meat. It's also about rounding up the numbers of carp caught so far, just so we can rip it out of the ones that aren't doing so well.
53. It's all right, first 48 hours.
The barbecues always go down a treat amongst the anglers, so thank you to Antonio, Ricardo and Lucia for putting them together.
Just got my 3 rods out after a lovely barbecue cooked by Ricardo, excellent again. 5:30 we started back on the rods. And James over there in Peg 12 has wasted no time at all. It's 6:10 now, he's had a double take, yeah? Absolutely superb. Only at Parco do you have that kind of action. One of them looked like quite a good chunk as well. So fingers crossed for a big one for him, but also to good luck to all the guys for tonight for more big fish here at the race 2023.
So I'm over in James' swim, and because he's getting a lot of runs, he's dying to get some more rods out. He's very kindly told me to play his fish for him while he gets his other rod out. Happy days. Got the biggest smile on my face ever right now.
Fair play to Jason. He spent all week running around Parco taking pictures of everyone and their captures. So it was nice to see him have a little go at playing one of these carp himself, even if it was a grassy.
Tuesday morning, massive temperature drop last night, down to sort of like 5-6 degrees, I think. Just starting to warm up a little bit now, but the fishing has definitely slowed down. Not so many catch reports in the WhatsApp group. Don't think the media crew were called out for any real massive fish just yet. Out in front of me in Peg 2, not a lot's going on. The fish still seem like holding out in the middle between Peg 1, Peg 12, Peg 13, that kind of area, in the Bermuda Triangle, as they call it in Parco. But I'm still really hopeful for a big fish. And I think with these autumn conditions now, it's definitely changed from summer into autumn, that there's a chance that a real big one's going to come out at the race 2023.
Well done, son.
Cheers, I know, mate.
Just done that.
Well done, that's all right.
58.6.
Now it's not the biggest of the week by any stretch of the imagination, but at £58 it's a new PB for Harry, a PB that won't be lasting long. The cooler weather's definitely pushed the carp into the deeper water in front of Peg 7 and 9, with this £40 being the second of the morning for Harry, and Josh opposite him joining in on the action too.
Right, so we've just been round to swim 9 to do some photos and some filming for Harry's just had a 50, new PB, 58 pound common. And would you believe it, on the way back, we've just come past Josh in swim 7, who's playing a fish which looks like an absolute lump by the way it's moving in the water. Happy days.
Although swim 7 and 9 in the deeper water were really kicking off, that triangular zone in the middle was also producing bites. First for Matt in swim 1, then for James in 12, who continued to feed regularly and continued to get bites regularly. James was getting plenty of action by this point, with double takes becoming a regular occurrence. However, he hadn't really managed any real big ones yet. But with a few days yet to go, anything can happen at Parco.
Up here with Matt then on peg 1. This will be his 10th fish. Having a good time?
Yeah, definitely. Like you say, 10 fish now and having to work at it to keep them coming, but steadily catching, which you can't really ask for much more.
Oh, Matt. Hey! 10 fish.
That was the last carp caught on Tuesday, just as well too, because the lads were going to need to rest up in preparation for Wednesday, the day where things really start to kick off.
I've got it. I've got a lot of fish out.
It's madness, this is me too. Proper carnage just blew it.
Wednesday really felt like the day things started to heat up in the race, especially for Josh. The heavy baiting was starting to work and it became obvious how things were going to pan out for him.
He must have come on the feed, you know, within the last half hour or so. It's been carnage in peg 7. We've had 3-4 fish in the last half hour. So, you know, hopefully there's more to come.
Feels like a good one then, Matt.
Yeah. Hell. Yeah, that's a big fish. Wow.
God. Well done, Matt. Well done.
Midweek now, just gone past the midweek point here at Parker de Brent Race 2023, and it's all started kicking off. We had a 24-36 hour period where it has gone a little bit quiet with the temperature drop, but today it's really started kicking off with Josh over in peg 7. He's just had 4 or 5 runs in a row, and then the highlight of the trip so far really is Matthew down in peg 1. He's just got a really big mirror matching his big common as well. Let's get it out and see how big it is.
You hope.
The That's 260s now for Matt, and a reminder to the rest of the crew of what swims in the waters of Parco. It's midweek now, and sometimes just witnessing a carp of that size is enough to refuel the fire, and it was certainly getting equally as hot over in Swim 9. It was like clockwork in Harry Swim by this point. Often when there was one bite to be had, there was another.
Oh yes!
Go on, Harry
boy! Well, we're fishing two rods together, they both sort of go at the same time. Same thing happened yesterday.
Wednesday evening here at the race, absolutely kicked off the day with a cooling weather. The fish have become very, very congregated. Still out in the middle here, peg one catching a absolutely beautiful 64 pounder, but up in top end of the lake, peg seven, peg nine, loads of fizzing, loads of sheeting going on out in the middle of the lake, and Josh and Harry up at that top end are catching really well. We're just reeling in now, 3:30, 4 o'clock barbecue, and then we'll be back out on it, and hopefully those guys are going to catch some more fish. Thinking about numbers here, so James in peg 12 is leading with the sort of like top rod position, nearly 30 fish, but I think Josh is catching him up now, and he's on about 20 and he's going to catch a lot of fish up there. Let's go and get something to eat.
Genuinely, look, I mean, look at that. Look how happy
he is.
Barbecue is beautiful once again, and as the heavens opened, everyone made their way back to the swims, but no one could have predicted what would happen next.
Long for the net, and that's a big net.
Well,
it's too long for the net, mate.
Oh,
seriously, it's too long.
That's a 60 pounder.
I don't know, it's not very deep at all.
What the f? That thing is massive.
Well done, Harry. A little bit out of breath, just come cycling round with the official scales with Harry here. 62 pound mirror, absolutely fishing fantastic. The second fish have moved down this end, Harry's got one on the mat, Josh has got one in the net opposite. It's all happening at the race.
I guess coming all this way is what you come for. It's only Wednesday and it's my second PB of the trip, so I'm pretty happy with that. It was 56 and then I got had a 58 yesterday, and then now I've got this 62 mirror, one of the longest fish I've ever seen. Probably is the longest.
Well done, Harry!
Oh yes.
Happy days. Well done, mate.
What a day. And just as we get into the famous Big Fish Thursday too, who knows what to expect?
Thursday morning here at the race. As you can see behind me, the lake is still losing heat. It's quite interesting, these conditions, because the air temperature is lower than the water temperature. You're reeling in leads, hook baits and that feel really, really warm. People are still catching really, really well. There's been 360s out altogether. One of the fantastic things about the way this competition's run is that everybody's in it till the last hour. There's lots of big fish in here to be caught, and that rod could go at any point.
The morning of day six was all about Josh.
Oh, you're away.
I'm away.
Just, well, they've been like 30s, mate.
At this stage in the week, Josh and James were neck and neck for the top rod spot, with both of them catching numerous carp every day. At this stage, however, neither of them had caught anything bigger than a mid-50. Perhaps that could change for both of them by the end of day 6. Bites were coming thick and fast, and with every carp netted, you couldn't help but feel like he was getting closer to that monster. Surely it was only a matter of time.
Josh here, around in peg 7. He's going for the top rod spot at the minute, up to about 30 fish. It's not a bad common he's got coming in now, and he's just relentlessly, he's a great angler for keeps bombing, working the spots. If he's not catching, then he makes the spots work for him. Bob, keep putting the bait in little and often, and he's doing the business here.
As we netted another small carp for Matt, we received a call from Josh. He had finally had his moment, and with what sounded like an absolute monster resting in the net, he could potentially have knocked Matt off the podium.
Another 60. Matthew's still in the lead. He's come up here. He was straight in there. Well done, though. Cracking common,
yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, well done. What a fish, mate.
Matt had escaped narrowly by a few pounds, but James had a lump now, and this one was looking much closer to that 64-4 leading fish. James had battled his way through smaller fish all week, so to finally land that lump he was after meant everything to him. He may have missed out on that big fish spot by a matter of ounces, but you wouldn't know it judging by that smile. Well done, James. We haven't seen much of Dave this week. I mean, that bank he was on didn't do many bites at all, really. However, this lump of a common was the result of persistence, and the beauty of Parco is that, although Dave hasn't had many bites, his next one could win him the competition.
Big Fish Thursday lived up to its name yesterday. with 260s being out. Josh up in peg 7 had a 61-12, and then over in peg 12 he wasn't going to be cheated out of it. He had a 64, only 4 ounces short of taking the lead, but equal to the biggest mirror, also at 64 from peg 1. It really did live up to that name. What's really interesting as well, you've got them key swims, so you've got 1, 7, 9, 12 that are really still producing loads of fish, but the fish have spread out a little bit as well. So you've got people in peg 20, so you've got Dave there, Danny in 21, he's caught one.
This is 43-4. I've been struggling all week. My second fish, second 40. They've been boshing all over me last night and I lost a unit, but this one absolutely makes up for it. Really glad. Lovely place, lovely people. Hopefully there's a couple more to be had.
Over in peg 3, in the last 10 minutes, there's been a 51. And that's really great for everybody. So you never know, the last 24 hours of competition, still really quiet in peg 2, but I'm actually hopeful for a big one. How does it feel that you're beating your dad at the minute?
Well, I know he'll blame it to the fisher in front of me and not in front of him. That he always have an excuse, but it's pretty good.
Yeah.
I'll have to rub it in on the way home.
Will you?
Similar to the other lads who had caught plenty so far, Harry wasn't scared to put the bait in. Despite rarely using a spom at home, he stepped out of his comfort zone and used it to good effect this week. And I think it's safe to say he was rewarded for his efforts. Let's go have a chat with Matt, the current Big Fish Trophy holder.
You fish with your dad, that's great to see. Yeah. There's great camaraderie between you two and helping each other out, but there's a little bit of competitive edge as well.
Well, yeah, like I say, we're here for one reason, to catch that big one, and yeah, want to help everyone out. Like I say, want everyone to catch, but as long as there are a couple of ounces under mine, I'm happy.
Even your dad.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Definitely. Yeah.
How much bait have you using?
120 kilos.
120 kilos? Yeah, 120. All with the spob? You've got all no bait
boat? No bait boat, no nothing. Okay. Keep the bait going in and the bites will keep on coming.
Just lastly then, what do you think to this event, as in the race competition, that even though you've caught all of those fish, somebody that maybe hasn't caught a fish could still win it in the last hour, really? What do you think, how it's organised?
That's why it's so good until the last minute, isn't it?
Yeah.
There's something to fish for, yeah, right until the final whistle. So as long as you've got a rod in the water, you've still got a chance of winning. So even if you're in one of the quieter swims and there's some of the guys, you know, sat there and it's been quite, you know, fairly quiet out in front of them and haven't had a lot of activity, you only need that one big fish late, you know, tomorrow morning, and you walk away the winner. It's a race.
That's right. That is the beauty of this competition. You can't step off the gas, and if you do, you might just miss out on that trophy carp. Remember, the winner will walk away with their holiday money back and 500 quid of tackle box vouchers, and anyone can win it until that last second. Wes had struggled all week, so it's really nice to see him getting on the action on the last day with this lovely clean mirror. That final evening was magic. As the sun set over the Italian sky for the final time, you couldn't help but reflect on what had been a brilliant week. Loads of PBs were smashed, dreams fulfilled, and plenty of laughs were had.
Gay, not gonna lie to you.
Yes, the race is a competition on paper, but in reality, it's so much more than that. The prize truly is a bonus, with the buzz of adventure and good times being the star of the show.
Last hour of the race, 2023 here at Parco, and Guy here, just short of £60, £59.12.
Fantastic fish. You've had some big ones out this bay, haven't you?
Yeah, all week. Been really good stamper fish, mate, yeah.
You had a good time, yeah?
Yeah, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Still an hour to go.
Yep.
Could someone do it? Well done, guy. Fantastic fish.
Oh. Cheers, thanks.
Right, first of all, thank you all very much for coming and participating in the race 2023. Some struggled, including myself. As you can tell, it's a bit of a putting your hand in the bag and the luck of the draw, yeah? Other anglers with them good swims fished really, really well, fished heavy.
The first part of the ceremony was to award the section winners. I split the lake up into sections and the angler who caught the biggest fish in their section wins £100 tackle box vouchers. Well done to Harry, Mark, James and Guy who won their sections. But now it's time for the big one, the one that everybody's after.
Excellent, that. There's your trophy there.
Brilliant, thank you very much.
And then your £500 of vouchers, look, hands full.
Everyone's tried really hard and luckily enough,
you've got peg one.
I've got the biggest fish. Doesn't matter what peg, it takes one fish, doesn't it?
So, yeah, that's it.
Yeah, had a great week. Thank you very much, Doc.
You had your eye on that. Well, thank you.
Well, there you have it, the end of the race at Parco 2023. From everyone at the Tackle Box, have yourself a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.